Hi students, good morning. How are you all? I hope you are all fine, right? Till yesterday, we learnt about the quantum theory and quantum mechanics. Today, we will start learning about quantum numbers. Why we have to learn quantum numbers, children? Okay, to describe an atom, we have to learn the quantum numbers. Then, how are we going to describe an electron inside the atom using the quantum mechanical model? Then, how are we going to describe the quantum mechanical model, children? While describing the quantum mechanical model of an atom, we are locating the probability of an electron's position around the nucleus inside the atom. We know that inside the atom, there will be a positive and positive charged protons and the neutral ones are neutrons. Those will be located inside the nucleus, and around the nucleus, the electrons used to rotate in their own paths. Am I right? So, how are we going to find out the revolving electron in a particular place? Okay. Using the quantum numbers, we are going to locate the position of the electron around the nucleus inside the atom. Okay, now what do you need to know to find out where you live exactly? Tell me. Suppose I ask you where are you living, then how are you going to address yourself? You are going to first tell about the state of it, and then the city where you live, and then the street where you live, and then the house where you exactly live in. Means this is how we are going to give us the address, right? Now this is what here the state refers in the quantum number. Just I'm giving you a matching example, children, that's all. Means here the state refers as for us principal quantum number, that is the main one, that is the main shell. Okay, the next one is about angular quantum number, and the next one is about magnetic quantum number, and the next one is about the spin quantum number. Means all the quantums, that means the quantum numbers, are like an address for the electron. Means how are we going to locate the position from the starting? How are we? Quantum mechanical model of an atom is made up of all the things like shell, then subshell, then orbitals, and then electrons. Got it, children? So quantum mechanical model of an atom has been made up of shell, that is what the main shell exactly where the electron is revolving, and then inside the shell there are some subshells. In that subshells there will be orbitals. In that orbitals where the electron exactly, that means to find out the electron, we should find out first what is the shell number, and then what is the subshell, and then inside that what is an orbital it has to be located, and then we can find out the electron. Okay, children, let's start learning about the quantum numbers. Coming to the quantum numbers. Quantum numbers are required to describe the distribution of an electron density in an atom. That means how to find out the electron, where it will be around the nucleus inside the atom, using the quantum numbers. Using the quantum numbers. How many quantum numbers are there? There are three quantum numbers necessary to describe an atomic orbital. What are those? The first one is principal quantum number. The second one is angular moment quantum number. And the third one is magnetic quantum number. Okay, let us first discuss about the principal quantum number. Now, see here, the principal quantum number designates the size of the orbital. It used to give away the size of the orbital. How is it? What is the size of the orbital stands for? The larger values of n corresponds to the larger orbitals. Larger values of n corresponds to the larger orbital. What does it mean, children? Suppose n is equals to, the values are starting from n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay. So, A collection of orbitals with the same value of n is frequently called as a shell. That means whatever are the numbers has been given over here, whatever are the numbers has been given over here, that will be referred as a shell. What it is? That will be referred as a shell over here. Okay, now let's see how it will be. Suppose the number, what is the number of the main shell and what is the alphabet which it is named with. Now let us take this as, what is this? Nucleus. Now here is one orbital. That means this is the shell, children. This is a shell. Okay. Now what is this shell number? N is equals to 1. That is what it is, alphabet with K. Now coming to the second shell, that is N is equals to 2. That means principal quantum number is represented with the letter N. Okay, the first one which is close to the nucleus is referred as 1. From there onwards it goes on, the numbers goes on increasing. Whenever we are going to increase the number, the size of the orbital also used to increase. The size of the orbital also used to increase. Now let's see the third one. The third one, if it is N is equals to 3, then it is M orbital. Then the next one, N is equals to 4, then that is for N orbital. Okay, children, are you getting my point? Okay, now let's see. Coming to the angular momentum quantum number, the next quantum number is angular momentum quantum number. So, the angular momentum quantum number L describes the shape of the orbital. Before that, what? It has decided the size of the orbit. Size of the orbit, that is what, the shell, that is the main shell we can say, and here L can be referred as the subshell, children. L can be referred as the subshell. Okay, see, the value of L are integers that depend on the value of the principal quantum number. The values of L are the integers that depend on the value of principal quantum number. How is it we related? The allowed values for the range of L is equals to 0 to n minus 1. L is equals to 0 to n minus 1. That means L in the sense is that having the different shapes, children. L is equals to 0, L is equals to 1. Means our principal quantum number starts from n is equals to 1 onwards. Okay, understood. So here L value starts from 0 onwards. If L is equals to 0, that will be referred as S orbital. And L is equals to 1 in the sense that will be referred as P orbital. And L is equals to 2 in the sense that is referred to as D orbital. L is equals to 3 in the sense that is referred to as F orbital. Getting my point, children? Right. Coming over here, if suppose, let us take an example. If N is equals to 2, then L will be what? 0 to N minus 1. What is N here? 2. So 2 minus 1 is what? 1. That is what? 0 to 1. That means N is equals to 2, it has both 0 as well as 1 also. That means it is used to have S orbital as well as P orbital also. Okay, a collection of orbitals with the same energy, same value of N and L are referred as subshell. Okay, these are what considered as SPDF are considered as what, children? Subshells. We are considering as subshells. See here, the shapes of the orbitals. This is S orbital, P orbital. See here, S orbital, then P orbitals. P orbitals are 3. There are 3 P orbitals. Only one S orbital will be there, children. Only one S orbital will be there. And there are 3 P orbitals. One is PX, PY and PZ. Okay. Now, see the D orbitals over here. D orbitals. DYZ, DXY, DXZ, dx square minus y square and dz square. These are the names, children. These are the names exactly. These are the names. What is the name of it? These are the names. S orbital. Here px is the name. S doesn't have any other, right? That's what simply S orbital we can say. Here p in the x orientation and y, this is in the y orientation. This orbital in the z orientation. Now this is in the y and z orientation. This is xy orientation. Here dxz in the sense xz orientation, dx square minus y square in the sense this is having a specific orientation, and here z square is another specific orientation. These are all the orbitals of D, and these are the orbitals of P, and this is the orbital of S. Okay, and then these are F orbitals. There will be 7 F orbitals, children. 1 s orbital, 3 p orbitals, 5 d orbitals, 7 f orbitals. How is this coming? These many number of orbitals. Oh, we have to calculate and see how these will be. There are 7 or something. Here, these are the names, children. These are the names of it as previous I showed you. Okay. How are we going to calculate? That means how the relation between n and l goes into l is equals to 0 to n minus 1. Based on this, let us see. If n equal to 1, then l will have only one value, that is l is equals to 0. 0 refers to as s orbital. Now, if n is equals to 2, l values from 0 to 1, that is l is equals to 0 comma 1, that is s comma p. Okay. So, yes, l is equals to 0 stands for s orbital, l is equals to 1 stands for p orbital. Okay. Now, if n is equals to 3, l values from 0 to 2, that is 0 comma 1 comma 2, 0 stands for s and 1 stands for p and 2 stands for d. Just now we saw those all. Okay. Then n is equals to 4 in the sense l values from 0 to 3, l is equals to 0 comma 1 comma 2 comma 3. Up to 3 we have to take. So these are the values of s, p, d, f. Maybe you are getting confusion. Ma'am, what are all these values? How to remember all these values? We are getting tense. Don't worry, children. I will demonstrate you with a nice picture to make you understand. Okay. So you need not worry about it. How the calculations goes on, let us see. How these calculations goes on. See, this is our nucleus. Now this is first orbit. Okay. This is the first orbit. What is its principal quantum number? N is equals to 1. Okay. That means it used to have one subshell, that is the name called as 1s. Are you able to understand, children? Slowly I will tell you. Just try to understand very clearly. Here is the first orbit, children. Here is the first orbit. That's what it is named as, N is equals to 1. And it has N equal to 1 in the sense the main shell number is equals to number of subshells. Okay, N is equals to 1. That's why it is having only one subshell. Now, second one now this is. Okay, N is equals to 2 now. N is equals to 2. So, it has two subshells. Those two subshells, what are those I told you before? S and P, right? That is what? Second subshell, that means second shell, it has two, that is 2S and 2P. This 2 stands for, it belongs to the second shell. If this 2 stands for, this belongs to the second shell. And S and P stands for the orbitals. Okay. Now, assume what will happen for the next third one? What will happen for the third one? Okay. The value of N is equals to 3. How many subshells it used to have, children? How many subshells? Yes. 3. What are these 3? Let us see. 3S, 3P, 3D. I hope so you all understood now. Okay, now n equal to 4. Now see n equal to 4. N equal to 4 in the sense it has 4. 4s, 4p, 4d and 4f. I hope so you got an idea now very clearly. Isn't it? N is equal to 1 means 1 subshell. N equal to 2 means 2 subshells. N equal to 3 means 3 subshells. N equal to 4 means 4 subshells. All should start from s itself. Suppose it belongs to 1 means 1s. If it belongs to 2 means 2s. Third shell it belongs to means 3s. If it belongs to fourth shell in the sense 4s. I hope you all understood, children, right? Let's go to the next one. Coming to the angular momentum quantum number here, see how these values has been given. For this first one, there are four shells we saw, right? There are four shells we saw. Now, let's see the values, how these has been calculated and how the places has been come for this. Now, this is the shell number n equal to 1. How many number of subshells, children? Number of subshells are how many? 1. Okay, what is the name of the subshell then? 1s. What is the value of it? L equal to 0. That's all. Okay, this 2 stands for n and s stands for l. Got it? So, n is equal to 2 means there are 2 subshells. N equal to 3 means 3 subshells. N equal to 4 means 4 subshells. Means 2 subshells are, one is S and another one is P, that's what 2S, 2P. There are 3 means SPD, 3S, 3P, 3D. Now 4 means it is having 4, that means 4 orbitals. So 4S, 4P, 4D, 4F. The S value, P value, D value, F value doesn't change, children, doesn't change. This is what our angular momentum quantum number. Okay. Now, coming to the magnetic quantum number. Let us see magnetic quantum number now. The magnetic quantum number ML describes the orientation of the orbital in the space of an atom. Okay, we saw the way where the electron will be till now. What in for, suppose in the first shell, if it is there, in which orbital it used to be. Okay, in that orbital, in which orientation it should be, will be described by magnetic quantum number. The values of ML are integers which depend on value of angular momentum quantum number. That is, ML is minus L to plus L. You observe one thing, children, here. N, we started the principal quantum number with N. Okay. And after that, angular momentum quantum number, it is depended on N. That is 0 to N minus 1. Now, magnetic quantum number, L depends on, ML depends on L. That is minus L to plus L. Got it? Okay, one is dependent on the other. One is dependent on the other. Let's see. See, the magnetic quantum number has integer values between L and plus L, including 0. Okay, L minus L and plus L, including 0. Thus, for a certain value of L, there are 2L plus 1 integer values of ML as follows. So, suppose minus L to plus L, that means minus L, minus L plus 1 and so on up to minus 1, 0 plus 1 and so on up to plus L minus 1 and plus L like that. Ha! By looking at this great formula, maybe you are got stuck. Okay, let us see some of the examples, then you can understand. When L is equals to 0, see here children, when L is equals to 0, if you substitute that L value into L plus 1, how much will you use to get? 1 you used to get. And there is only one value of ML, thus we have only one orbital, that is S. Okay, only one value, right? That's what, only S. Now, coming over here, when L is equals to 1, again substitute, you will get 3. You will get 3. That means ML has 3 values, namely minus 1, 0, plus 1, or 3 orbitals with different orientations along the XYZ axis. These are labeled as PX, PY and PZ. I show you already in the shapes of the orbital. You remember, children? Shall we go back to the shapes of the orbital? See, L is equals to 0 in the sense it is S orbital. It has only one place. That, did you see this? You remember this first of all? P, that is PX, PY, PZ. There are 3 places. I showed you already 3. Okay, one S orbital I showed you, and then the 3 P orbitals in the X direction, Y direction and Z direction. In that case, how many D orbitals will be there, children? Okay, in this way we are going to calculate the number of degenerated orbitals. What do you mean by this degenerated orbitals, children? Degenerated. What do you mean by degenerated? Orbitals in the same shell possess the same energy. These are called degenerated orbitals. Means, now S is having only one orbital. Okay, one degenerate orbital. Means, did you see that there is a spherical shaped, red colored ball, spherical shape I showed you before. Okay, that is what the S orbital. We don't have any problem with that because it is having only one. So, it has nothing else. And coming to P, there are 3 orbitals I showed you already. I showed you already 3 orbitals, PX, PY, PZ orientations. There are 3 positions. That means those PX, PY, PZ are the orientation, 3 orientations of P. And coming to D, I already showed you the 5, that is YZ, XZ and XY, X square minus Y square and Z square. If you want, you can go back to the video and then see those are the degenerate orbitals. Okay. And then F also I showed you already 7. Okay. These are the number of degenerated orbitals in each subshell. In each subshell. S does not have any degenerated orbitals. It is having only one. So, does no problem at all. And P, it has 3 degenerated orbitals. Okay. How these will be calculated and how these will be represented? In this way, how these will be calculated in this way. Let us see. N is equals to 1 in the sense L value as 0, ML value 0. That is what the subshell notation. children, you just try to practice this. You just try to practice this by observing this. You just try to practice to note down all the values. I will demonstrate you with a picture now. See here. See here. Now you observe very carefully, children. This is the nucleus for us. Okay, this is the first shell. This is the first shell. In this, I have only one subshell which is having the value L is equals to 0. That means, see the degenerated orbital. Means I have mentioned all the degenerated orbitals with a single box over here. Box structure. Okay. 1s and 2s and 3s and 4s. All are having only one degenerated orbital which is named with 0. Which is named with 0. Now P is having 3 degenerated orbitals. Those 3 degenerated orbitals are mentioned with minus 1, 0, plus 1. Now I hope you understand. Okay. This minus 1 is for px and this is for py and this is for pz. Px, py, pz you have to mention. Now coming to the d orbital, it has 5, right? So 5 degenerated orbitals which are naming as minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. Now coming over here for f, 4f. Okay, L value is 3, of course. So that's what it is, from minus 3 to plus 3. By observing all these In this picture itself, all I have mentioned, all the three quantum numbers I have mentioned. What are those? The principal quantum numbers. See here. With the yellow color, I have mentioned all the numbers. N equal to 1, N equal to 3, N equal to 2, N equal to 3, N equal to 4. All the 4 I have given with the principal quantum number this is. Now, angular quantum number, what is that? L equal to 0, L equal to 1, L equal to 2, L equal to 3, these are all the quantum numbers with the shapes of the orbitals s p d f. Okay, right. Now so here what I told you, L is equals to 0, L is equals to 1, L is equals to 2, L is equals to 3. All the S and P orbitals and D orbitals and F orbitals I have mentioned for you. And ML values depends on minus L to plus L, right? Now you observe over here, L equal to 1 in the sense minus L, that is minus 1 to plus 1. Suppose L is equals to 2 in the sense it is minus 2 to plus 2. And L is equals to 3 means minus 3 to plus 3. I hope you all understood the values, how these will be arranged using this picture, right? Well, very well understood, children. I hope so. So let's get back to the next one now. This is how we are going to calculate the maximum number of electrons that can be filled either in each orbital or in each shell. Okay. For it to find out how many number of electrons should be filled in each orbital, that should be calculated with 2L plus 1. That is the value with 2L plus 1. And suppose if you want to know how many number of electrons will be placed in the total shell, that is using the formula 2N square. Okay. Using the principal quantum number it is. This is what the angular quantum number. Okay. Now let's see. Here one degenerated orbital. Each degenerated orbital will consist of 2 electrons, children. Now you can calculate easily. 1 degenerate orbital means 2 electrons. 3 means 3 into 2, 6 electrons. 5 degenerated orbitals, 5 into 2, it is 10. Now 7 degenerated orbitals, 7 into 2, 14. How? I gave you boxes like structures, right? In each box, there are 2 electrons. In each box, there will be occupation of 2 electrons. So, in that way, while we are going to count for the maximum number of electrons, in the first shell only S is there, right? That's why it has only 2 electrons. And the next N is equals to 2, that is in the second shell, it has both S and P, right? S and P. See here, S and P, both are there. So 2 plus 6, how much? 8. Now, afterwards we have S, P, D, total. So 2 plus 6 plus 10, that is what? 18. Now, in the last shell, that is the fourth shell, we have all the 4, S, P, D, F, that is what? 2 plus 6 plus 10 plus 14, how much it will be? 32. In this way, we are going to find out how many number of electrons has been filled inside the atom. Now, let's see. Coming to the next quantum number, which has been not introduced before, that is what? Spin quantum number. The electron spin quantum number is used to specify an electron's spin. Spin means how it is going to rotate, that means revolve around the nucleus. One is a clockwise, another one is anti-clockwise direction. Okay, clockwise direction. Clockwise in the sense how the needle in our clock used to move in that direction, that is a clockwise. Opposite to the clockwise direction, that is anti-clockwise direction. So it has allowed the values of ms, r, plus half and minus half. Suppose there is a degenerate orbital. Okay, children, this is the s orbital I'm taking, the degenerate orbital sc I'm taking. Okay, now here are the two electrons. Here are the two electrons. One is with plus half orientation. That plus half orientation will be with the upward arrow, and the minus half orientation will be the downward arrow. Okay, this is what the spin quantum number tells us about. This is what the spin quantum number, spin in the sense it is going to rotate, that means revolve. Okay, there are two electrons. These two are not fighting with each other, children. They are going in their own way. One is going in the left direction, one is going in the down direction. That means up direction, one electron is revolving in the upward direction in the clockwise, another one is revolving in the downward direction in the anti-clockwise direction. So that means there is no clash in the electrons while those are revolving around the nucleus inside the atom. Okay, how these electrons will be placed, arrangement of electrons in the orbitals, let us see. This is my s orbital. Okay, right, see these electrons, observe very carefully, slowly. First electron has been occupied, the second electron came and occupied. Then this is my p, it has three degenerated orbitals, children. P is having three degenerated orbitals. So each degenerated orbital will be occupied. First of all, px will be occupied first, then py, then pz. Then it will be coupled. That means second orbital will be filled over, like second electron will be filled over like this. Now coming to d, it has five degenerated orbitals. I have represented the five degenerated orbitals with the five different boxes, children. Now this is the d. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, total five electrons has been occupied in singly in each degenerated orbital. Afterwards it will be paired. Okay, like this it used to pair up with the 10 electrons. Now coming to the f, it used to have seven degenerated orbitals, right? So these are the seven electrons, first occupied the single, then it used to pair up with. Got it, children? This is what the arrangement of electrons in the orbitals. Maybe you are surprising, ma'am, why only first all should be filled with a single one, why not with all the pairs? So to understand that, we have to understand the concept called, there are some of the principles behind it, children. There will be a Pauli's exclusion principle and Aufbau principle, okay, and Hund's rule. Based on all this, why the electrons having the different spin, with how these electrons are being seen, why these are singly occupied first and the next one. And in the next class, we are going to learn about how the electronic configurations, we are going to write for the atom. Okay, children. Okay, revise all the concept what we have discussed till now. The one if you did not understand, you just try to get back to the video and just go back and then try to revise and try to understand better. Okay, children. Meet you in the next class. Thank you so much. And if you understand the concept of all these quantum numbers to write them properly, then only we are able to write down the electronic configurations of the atoms. Thank you so much, children. Take care. Bye.